Previously on Balls. Hey, France, Darren, how's it going, buddy?
Lekker, thanks, and you?
Very, very good, thanks. Long time no speak.
Yeah, man, are you well?
Yeah, very good, man, and you?
Yeah, no, I'm also well, thank you. It's been an interesting year.
Has it? Yeah,
I've been able to make another movie. Listen, I made a mistake. I'm actually beginning to board now. The plane will leave at 3:40.
At 3?
At 3:40, 4.
All right.
Any chance of chatting to me a little bit earlier, or then maybe...
We can chat to you right now.
Sure.
We're ready to go right now. So, I mean, tell us about the interesting year that you've had. Johnny just came in and said, no, we've got to talk to France early because he's got a new movie that's coming out. Is it done already? Are you still busy shooting? What's the story?
No, we finished shooting and we released the movie 2 weeks ago on DVD. Okay. And it's already in schools countrywide.
All right.
And feedback's really good. We decided not to go to cinema. Because the movie has got a Christian message and an inspirational sort of uplifting message, we're making a movie available for churches and schools and clubs to screen the movie in their facilities. And then also at the same time, we're releasing the movie as a download for online download on the internet worldwide.
Cool.
So that's also been interesting to see how people respond to that.
Awesome. All right, give us a little bit of a very brief synopsis of what the movie's about.
The movie is, when we started making the movie, we knew we were going to make it with very little budget and had ASG Sport Solutions involved, who's an importer of bicycles.
Yeah.
So we wanted to show their products in the movie as well. So the movie is goes about a guy who lost his job in the recession, and he struggled to look after his family. And in the end, the only way that he can earn a bit of money again is to do bicycle deliveries. And in that process, he becomes stronger and in the end enters the Burger Cycle Tour down in Stellenbosch.
Okay.
And that's where we got Philippe involved. He's the actual commentator in the movie.
Mm.
And the cycling action really came out really well. And I think the combination of the fairly serious subject matter combined with the uplifting cycling and sports action has really been a good combination in the movie.
Mm, that's awesome, and that is really, really good. And from an acting point of view, I mean, you say Phil Liggett's in there, who else have you included?
I play the lead role of the guy that loses his job in the recession.
Okay.
My editor, Mornay, plays Eli Pavoncelli, who's an Italian bicycle shop owner who becomes my mentor. And he organizes a sponsorship where the guys from ASG present me with a Pinarello's Dogma, the best bicycle in the world to cycle with.
Mm-hmm.
And my production designer, Etienne, plays my long-lost brother in the movie.
So
we decided to keep the acting in-house, and that was a fairly interesting process in itself because that meant that I had to produce, direct, write, and act in the movie. And so did my editor and my production designer. We all had to multitask.
Mm.
But we're really, really so thankful that the movie has come out as well as it did. And it really has opened up a whole new avenue of possibilities for us because of the model in which we made the movie.
And you've saved yourself a heap of budget on exorbitant actors' costs and a whole lot of others as well.
Yeah, I just came from a big funding corporation this morning who's very interested in the way that we made this movie.
Yeah.
Because exactly that, you know, we save a lot on budget and on the risk involved. It's a totally debt-free way of financing a movie. And it opens up the possibility for African filmmakers to make more movies.
Yeah, absolutely, especially as money is very tight at the moment. I mean, the whole story of the movie is very pertinent to the position some people are in that might want to make a movie and can't because that for that very reason.
Exactly, but not just movie makers, Darren. It's also people in business in general. You know, it's been so tough that a lot of people are finding it difficult to get going again. And the message in the movie is stop looking out there, but actually look around you and use what you've got.
Mm.
And in using what you've got, it's amazing how much you can actually accomplish.
Yeah. I think that's where life was intended to be from the beginning, right?
Say again?
I think that, isn't that what life was intended to be at the beginning?
Exactly.
This is the way the world is just getting us back to our origins again.
Yeah, we all make life too complicated, and then every now and then a few checks happen, and you know, we have to get fitter again, we have to lose a bit of weight, we have to get more healthy, we have to look at a different way with our finances. And even though it's a tough process, it can also be very good.
Yeah. Tell me, how did the Hansi movie do, by the way?
That's been an interesting process where we released Hansi in 2008 in South Africa, but it's taken a long time to get released in India and in America. In India, I'm actually still waiting for royalty reports, so I don't have any figures, but I know that in the first month of the release there, it went to the top 10 best-selling English movies on DVD in India.
Awesome.
In America, it's sort of had an average start, but that's mainly because people see the cricket and they're not sure what it's about. But
as
they watch it, they realize it's a story about life.
Mm.
So we're beginning to get some really good feedback from that. And also the Hansi movie has been on Mnet recently again.
Yeah,
it's amazing the feedback we keep on hearing from people.
Yeah, well, that's fantastic. And the family all good otherwise?
Yeah, very well, thanks. My dad's health's not greatest, but they seem to be doing really well. We'll see them over Christmas time down in Cape Town.
Awesome. Well, please send our best regards to everyone and look after yourself. Travel safely over Christmas. Good luck. By the way, the name of the movie is?
Now, the name of the movie is a little bit difficult. It's Barodier. It's French for fighter.
Yeah.
But if you want to get details about it and you can't remember Barodier, which is Barodeur, just look for francecronier.com, which is a little bit easier to remember, and you'll be able to trace it from there.
francecronier.com, and also details if you want to get it online. I suppose that's the best place to go as well.
Exactly, yeah.
Awesome stuff. Francis, lovely to chat to you again, man. We wish you everything of the best for the movie. Have a great Christmas. As I say, send love and regards to the family, and look forward to catching up again sometime in 2013.
That'll be fantastic. It's great hearing your voice again, Darren.
Oh, that's funny, best, man. Bye-bye.
Thanks, okay, Francis.
Cheers, Francis. Bye-bye. There we go. Francis Cronier, brother of the late Hansi Cronier, who did the movie Hansi, which you might have seen on him. Did you ever watch that movie?
I watched it, Darren. Yeah, it was quite moving. I must admit, I enjoyed it.
Now I've done this movie, Barodier. So francecronier.com if you want more details how you can get it. It's available only on DVD and also on online.
This is Paul's Visual Radio. Darren, Simon, Kate and John. Weekdays from 3 p.m. to 6 p.m. Central African Time. Paul's.co.za.